So now let's find solutions. For PLLs, so which lock on phase modulated signals, and these solutions they're usually called Costas loops. Costas loops. So the main idea behind all these Costas loops or variations of this is that that these loops eliminate the phase information. So remember, the phase information is transmitted in the way that we have our S of t, and then is multiplied by cosine of 2 pi f0. So that was here our carrier. And these are our symbols here. Remember, we can also have this as a sine, cosine, sine combination for quadrature. But the idea is that basically that the Costas loop Costas loops ignore this term or eliminate them. And there, so initial idea by Costas, who has probably nothing to do with the coffee shop chain, was developed in the 50s. The idea is to use both sine and cosine from the VCO and create the voltage by combining these two pathways. So the we're looking at the circuit diagram or data flow diagram of this. It looks a bit like a quadrature demodulator. So here we've got our VCO. And the VCO generates an output of 2 cosine of omega 0 t plus theta 0. And then does a low pass filtering. And the VCO also generates a minus 2 sine omega 0 t plus theta 0 and does again a multiplication operation here. So we use basically both pathways of the VCO, and then we've got our input signal. So that's here our input signal, and the input signal now has S of t, so it's our symbol stream, and then this multiplied by cosine of omega 0 t plus psi. So important here is we've got this S of t, which wouldn't mess up a normal PLL circuit. Just now we just think of real symbols here. And so also this one here does the low pass filtering here. And so now the trick is that we take these two signals here we've generated from your from these two quadrature pairs and multiply them, do another low pass filtering, and then we send that into our VCO. And and this, if you're building a circuit like that, then if you're doing the math for that, the magic is that this signal here, what we're getting out here is half sine 2 delta phi. And remember, delta phi was our error signal here, that is psi minus theta 0. So that's our error signal here. So that's the Costas loop a bit shrinked down. And so therefore we can analyze this circuit and see why this is giving us this result. So for example, if we're looking here at this pathway, then this is multiplied, the S of t multiplied with this cosine term here, and then with the other cosine term here. So at this point here, we have something like S of t cosine of omega t plus psi, and then multiplied by 2 cosine of omega 0 t plus theta 0. So that's what is happening here at this point in the circuit. And so now we just apply the classical trigonometric information here. So the S of t stays, and then we have something like cosine of psi minus theta 0, and then this plus cosine of 2 omega 0 t plus psi plus theta 0. And so bracket closed here. So we see already here this one is again our error term here, so that's delta phi. So that's our correction term. So basically what we have here, so after the low pass filtering here at the output, we have S of t multiplied by cosine of delta psi. So that's the output. So we can do exactly the same on the other side here, which is obviously exactly the same idea, that we multiply this cosine with the sine here, with the same recipe. And then on this side here, we're getting out S of t and then sine delta phi here at this point. And so then the only thing what we need to do is we just need to multiply these two signals here to get this output here. So in the middle, then we're getting S of t squared, and then we are getting cosine delta phi multiplied by sine delta phi. So that's what we are getting here in the middle. So we can again change that with our standard trigonometric operations here, and then this gives us here half of sine 2 delta phi, and with a sine of 0 term, which is obviously 0, and with the other assumption that this one is here 1, because the if we have just binary symbols here, let's assume this here, they're just with s of t equals 1 or minus 1. So these are the two options. So then here at this point, we're getting this out here. And we see, because of the squaring of the s of t here, our symbol stream has disappeared. And at this point here, so we have a nice and clean just sign information here, which is driving the VCO. Remember, in the classical PLL, this was sine of delta phi. So classical PLL was sine of delta phi. So Costa's loop gives us sine of 2 delta phi. So that's the only difference, but the beauty of this is that as a result out of this, the symbol stream is eliminated. So symbol info eliminated.